months back. Then he developed an ulcero-proliferative growth in the penis, which was insidious in onset. Initially, it was smaller in size and gradually progressive to attain the present size, which was associated with the discharge and not associated with the pain. History of foul-smelling discharge present. History of inability to retract foreskin present. No history of urethral discharge or recent sexual activity. Coming to past history, history of circumcision done 11 months back for phimosis. No history of contact with multiple sexual partners. Coming to personal history, patient is a smoker for past 31 years, 100 BDs per day, and an alcoholic for past 30 years, 200 ml per day. Family history, history of pericarcinoma larynx in father present.
On examination, general examination was found to be normal, and systemic examinations were including respiratory system and per abdomen was found to be normal. On examination of penis, an ulcero-proliferative growth of 3x3 cm involving glans penis, and there was foul-smelling discharge present, and margins were ill-defined, surface was irregular, and edge was averted. The floor covered with minimal slough, around 4 cm of penile shaft is free from the proximal margin of the tumor. Urethral meatus was found to be at the floor of the ulcer with adequate flow of urine when we asked the patient to pass urine, and no discharge from the meatus was seen. On palpation, it was not tender, not warm. The inspectory findings regarding site, extent, shape, surface and margins were confirmed. And the consistency was hard, base was indurated, and it does not bleed on touch. Extent of the induration was 1 cm proximal to the lesion, and urethral meatus was found to be at the base of the ulcer. On examination, bilateral inguinal region, multiple enlarged non-tender mobile lymph nodes which were firm in consistency were palpated, and scrotum was found to be normal with bilateral testes were palpable separately, and other cardiovascular system and respiratory system were found to be normal. Per abdomen, there was no iliac nodes or para-aortic nodes palpable, and liver was found to be normal. Per rectum, the prostate was found to be normal, and there was a sphincter tone which was normal. Thank you.
What's the diagnosis?
Provisional diagnosis. Carcinoma of penis involving glans penis with bilateral palpable inguinal nodes, which comes to T3, N2 and MX.
What is T stage here? What are the T stages?
TIS is carcinoma in situ. TA is non-invasive carcinoma penis. T1 is divided into A and B. T1A is carcinoma penis involving the subepithelial connective tissue without urethral invasion, without lymphovascular invasion. T1B is involvement of subepithelial connective tissue with lymphovascular invasion.
So up to T1 is a non-invasive, and T2, T3 are invasive one. Whether that is any important for that, invasive or non-invasive type, like a stage T3 or T2, is any important for that, for a nodal?
The possibility of involvement of inguinal lymph node is high when there is lymphovascular invasion.
So whenever the T stage increases or invasiveness increases, the chances of nodal mets is increasing.
Can you name some pre-malignant lesions of the penis?
Cutaneous horn, erythroplakia of Quirret, leukoplakia, Bowen's disease, pseudoepitheliosis, micaceous keratinitis, melanitis erotica obliterans.
Anything else? Something
condylom
that's more common?
Condylom acuminata. HPV infection.
Of all the things that you listed, what are the ones that we see commonly?
HPV infection.
And?
16.
Chronic balanophosphatitis. All right. You said in your presentation, you said multiple lymph nodes bilateral. Is that how you'll present, or would you like to qualify that? You can't just say multiple lymph nodes both sides, right? That's effectively what you said.
We can group the superficial inguinal nodes into 5. One is central.
What did you have in your case? That's what I'm asking.
Bilateral, supromedial, superficial inguinal lymph nodes, which were non-tender and mobile.
Size
maximum 2x2 cm on the both sides, ma'am.
Okay, so that detail needs to come in before you make a diagnosis of N2.
Okay.
And the consistency?
Firm in consistency.
Okay, so all that detail needs to come into your presentation when you're presenting in the examination.
What is the upper limit of the growth?
Proximal limit of the growth was once on palpation, we could palpate 1 centimeter proximal to the corona of the glands.
Proximal to the corona. Yes. Okay. What is meant by glands penis?
Sir?
What is meant by glands penis?
You said 11 months ago he had a circumcision, right?
Yes,
did the wound heal at that point in time?
Yes. Wound healed, ma'am. And it was
and what
was
the indication for surgery then?
Phimosis, ma'am. Indication was phimosis. He was a chronic patient. Since childhood, he had phimosis, ma'am. And there was no narrowing of the prepucial meatus since childhood. But 11 months back, he developed meatal stenosis. Prepucial meatus stenosis. Then difficulty in passing urine was developed. So he underwent phimosis.
What will you do for this patient? What will you do for this patient?
Partial amputation of penis.
You always investigate before
incision.
You always say investigations before management, all right? So what do you want to confirm the diagnosis by?
Edge wedge biopsy.
I'm sorry?
Edge wedge biopsy.
Okay, what do you hope to see?
Depth of invasion, lymphovascular invasion.
No, when you take the biopsy, what are you seeing?
Type of malignancy, whether it is squamous cell carcinoma or...
How do you know a tumor is squamous cell carcinoma?
Keratin pearls will be present.
All right. And then what else?
Mitotic figures will be present.
What else do you want to see in investigation?
Depth of invasion, lymphovascular invasion from biopsy.
Okay. And then?
Grading of tumor.
Yes?
So this patient, before going for biopsy, any other investigation you want to do?
Other than routine investigations, we can go for imaging studies like
yes. What imaging abdomen, study you want to do?
Ultrasound abdomen, CT abdomen, and MRI for penis.
No, the MRI of penis is important or not? Why? So you said the partial penectomy, your things. So if it is involved on the cavernosa is present, can you do a partial penectomy? Because the growth is bigger growth, T3 lesion. Still, you want to do a partial penectomy?
If the stump is more than 2.5 or 2 centimeters, then
no,
we can...
No, once the cavernosa is involved, I think you cannot do a partial penectomy. That's why you have to do an MRI of the penis, so you can able to document it, whether it's involved or not.
Do you do any investigation for the lymph nodes? Do you suspect secondaries from CA penis?
Metastatic? Sir, 50% of all the palpable inguinal nodes are due to reactive lymphadenitis, and FNAC can be done. If it shows malignancy, then we can go for ipsilateral superficial contralateral superficial inguinal lymphadenectomy plus ipsilateral ilioinguinal dissection.
Supposing you think that it is a malignant node, but your FNAC is not conclusive, is there any other test that you can do, sir, given the fact that you said 50% are reactive?
Yes.
Sentinel lymph node biopsy can be done.
Yes?
Sentinel lymph node.
Can you tell me about it? Explain that.
Isosulfan blue dye is injected.
Speak into the mic, please, so that the rest of the audience can hear you.
Isosulfan blue dye is injected into the lesion. Gamma probe is...
Into the lesion?
Peritumorally.
All right.
Then gamma camera is used to detect the node which is taking the dye.
Why do you need a gamma camera for a dye?
The sentinel node takes up that dye and it will become blue in color, and we can excise and send it for frozen section. Then if it turns out to be malignant, then we can proceed.
Okay, so this question turned to be an involvement of cavernosa as a T3 lesion. So high grade tumor, T3 lesion, involvement of muscle, So always the node, how much positivity? More than 50% of the nodes will be positive for that. No. So what's your treatment for that patient?
Total penectomy with bilateral superficial inguinal lymphadenectomy, which we will send for frozen section. If it turns out to be malignant, then we will go for ipsilateral ilioinguinal block dissection.
Are you planning for bilateral nodal dissection at the same time?
If frozen section shows positivity, then we can go for bilateral lymphadenectomy. If it is negative, then we can wait for 2 weeks with antibiotics, and if it's not settling down, then we can go for dissection, sir.
You know, on the first setting itself, you are going for a total penectomy with node dissection, or you wait for some weeks, you want to do a secondary lymphadenectomy?
So there has been studies saying that immediately on the same setting, if we do inguinal dissection, the survival prognosis is better. But in some books, it says we have to wait for 2 weeks with antibiotics. Then it's not settling down. Then we'll go for a lymphadenectomy.
So whenever the lesion is bigger one, you expect nodes may be positive. Then you can go over the same sitting. You can do that. Yes. Oh, what is the dressless quadrangle?
Line joining anterior superior iliac spine and pubic tubercle. And line drawing 20 centimeters from the ASIS and 15 centimeters from pubic tubercle.
Downwards to the thigh.
That's the only line. That is not a quadrangle.
Connecting all these lines.
Eh? Connecting.
No quadrangle.
What is the significance one?
For inguinal node dissection.
What type of standard?
Classical dissection. Sir.
Yes.
Apart from surgery, not particularly in this case, is there any other treatment option available for carcinoma penis?
Radiotherapy and chemotherapy.
What type?
External beam radiotherapy.
External beam.
Or iridium or tantalum wire can be placed inside the lesion. Okay. A total dosage of 6,000 centigrade for seven days.
Is there any chemotherapy?
Available, sir.
What is Buschke Lowenstein tumor?
It is a type of varicose carcinoma caused by human papilloma virus. It is a locally destructive tumor.
What type of human papilloma virus?
16.
6 and 11.
6 and
11. Yes, then? How the growth will be?
Proliferative growth.
It's a varicose.
It is varicose and it is locally invasive but does not have any
It has got a good prognosis or a bad prognosis?
Good prognosis, sir.
Can you do a radiotherapy or not?
Radiotherapy is ineffective, sir.
It increases the... It's aggressive. It increases aggressiveness. So only the you can do a partial penectomy in the type of cases.
Look.
Anything? Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
The two different topics we discussed, the cervical lymphadenopathy, the most difficult and challenging case when given the examination, where you have to tell the differential diagnosis as expected by the panel of examiners. And carcinoma penis is a short case, and the candidate has done very well.
Thank you, sir. I now request Professor Dr. R. Kannan, Director, Institute of General Surgery, Madras Medical College, and Professor Dr. Vivekanandan, sir, from Chettinad Medical College to present our panelists with certificates of honor. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am.